Hello and welcome to your evening wind down. A practice to relax and ease out from the stresses of the day that you might have had. So just bring yourself down onto your mat. Find your comfortable seat, cross-legged or kneeling. Whatever feels best in your body this evening. And straight away begin to close down the eyes. Turning your attention inwards. And leaving whatever kind of day you might have had behind you. Find that tall, straight spine, grounding down into the mat with the sit bones and lifting up out of the crown of your head. And bring your awareness to your breath. Breathing in and out through your nose. And seeing if you can take the length of your exhale equal in length to your inhale. Creating a slow, even, steady rhythm of breathing. Equally in through your nose. And equally out through your nose. And I invite you to keep this breath in mind throughout your practice. So when the mind starts to wander and drift back to thoughts from your day, just bring your awareness back to your breath. And this evening we'll use the breath and a slow pace in our practice to wind down and allow you to relax into your evening. Taking one more deep inhale through the nose, filling up the lungs. And release that breath with a sigh. Letting the breath go, allowing the shoulders to drop away from your ears and beginning to blink open the eyes. And we'll begin to just open up through the neck and the shoulders. And whatever kind of day you might have had, your shoulders are probably a lot closer to your ears than they were when you woke up. So to begin with, just take a couple of shoulder rolls, moving with your breath. As you inhale, draw the shoulders up towards the ears. And as you exhale, allow the shoulder blades to slide down the back. Inhaling up. Exhaling down, one more time. Coming back to meet in the center. And then bringing your right hand to the left ear on the outside of the head. And gently allow your right ear to drop towards your right shoulder. Not pulling on the head, just allowing gravity to work. Opening up through the left-hand side of the neck. And you could rest the hand on the knee or just begin to extend that left arm out beside you. Perhaps intensifying the stretch. And from here, you could just begin to flex the wrist and point the fingers. And just noticing if this changes the sensation in the neck, the shoulder, perhaps right down through the arm. Taking one more deep breath here. And then gently beginning to lower the left hand back to the knee, release the right hand off the head, and slowly draw your head back up to face the center. swapping to the other side. Bring the left hand to your right ear, so on the right side of the head, and gently allow the left ear to drop towards the left shoulder. Not pulling on the head, just allowing gravity to help you, that hand just weighing the head down slightly. As we lengthen the right hand side of the neck, perhaps into the shoulder, hand could rest on the knee, or again, extend that right arm out beside you. And perhaps this makes the stretch a bit more intense. If you want more, you could always begin to flex that wrist and then point the fingers. Just noticing if this changes any of the sensations in the neck, the shoulder, perhaps down into the arm. Take one more deep breath here. And then gently releasing the right hand down, release the left hand down, and slowly lift the head back up to find the center, moving really gently. And then from here, we take one more shoulder roll, just to ease out through the shoulders and the neck. And then on your next inhale, reach the arms out and up, gaze up towards the fingertips. And on your exhale, take a twist to your left hand side. Allow your right hand to drop to your left knee, left hand behind you, and gaze over the back shoulder. Perhaps noticing if there's any more space in your neck than normal. And perhaps it feels tight, and that's okay. Take one more deep breath here in this twist. And then as you inhale, lift back up, find the center, gaze up towards the thumbs. And then exhale, take that twist to the right hand side, allowing the left hand to drop to the right knee, right hand behind you, gaze over the back shoulder, keeping that tall, straight spine. Take one more deep breath on this side. And as you next inhale, lift back up, find the center, gaze up. And exhale, draw your hands through prayer heart center and bow your chin towards your chest. Perhaps finding that length along the back of the neck now. One more inhale. And then as you exhale, come to find your hands and knees, moving into your tabletop position. And we connect movement and breath here in our cat-cow. So as you inhale, drop the belly, gaze forwards. And then exhale, round through your back, gaze towards the belly button. Inhale, drop the belly, gaze forwards. And exhale, round through your back, chin comes towards your chest. And just continuing to take a couple more of these cat-cow movements. Moving with your breath, finding your own rhythm. And moving in a way that feels good for you this evening. If you've had a busy day on your feet, it might feel nice to take these nice and slow. Notice all the sensations in the body. Or if you've had a busy day at work and you spent a lot of it sat at your desk, it might feel nice to just wake up into the spine, bring a little bit extra movement into your body here. Wherever you are, take one more full round of breath. Come back to find the center and slowly begin to walk the hands back towards your knees, tuck your toes under, and we're coming to find a toe stretch. So just walk your hands back and sit the weight of your body back down onto your heels, toes tucked under. Now, if this is too much for you straight away, you can always just lift your bum off your heels, still opening up through the feet. Or sink back, rest the hands on the thighs. Come back to your breath. Breathing in through your nose and out through your nose. As we begin to open up through the fascia of the feet. Again, perhaps you spent your day taking lots of steps, doing lots of walking, and this might feel nice to stretch out. Or perhaps you didn't. Again, the sensations might feel different. And just notice. Take one more deep breath here. And then as you exhale, gently begin to lift the bum off the heels, walk your hands out in front of you, back into that tabletop position, untuck the toes, and just tap the tops of the feet down onto the mat beneath you, releasing out any tension that might have built up. And then returning to tuck the toes, but this time we lift the hips up and back and come to find your downward facing dog. Now, the first down dog of the practice, but it might be your first of the day. You know, just begin to bring movement into the posture, perhaps pedaling through your legs, pedaling through the shoulders, swaying hips side to side, creating space in the back of the body, and finding any movements that feel good for you this evening. Take one more inhale through your nose. And exhale, release it with a sigh. Arriving in stillness in your downward facing dog. You can keep a bend through the knees if the backs of the legs feel tight. Lift the sit bones up towards the ceiling, draw the belly back towards the thighs. And then keeping the feet where they are, on your next inhale, lightly begin to walk your feet forwards towards the top of the mat. Bending the knees deeply when you land and begin to uncurl up through your spine all the way up to standing, rolling the shoulders up, down and back, and then inhaling straight away. We reach the arms up overhead and exhale, fold, bend the knees and curl back down into your ragdoll position. So this time we take hold of opposite elbows, sway side to side. You can bend the knees as much as you need to here as we open up through the backs of the legs, ease into the lower back. Take one more deep breath in through your nose and out through your nose. Release hold of the elbows. Again, bend through the knees and uncurl through your spine all the way up to standing. Rolling the shoulders up, down and back. Exhaling at the top. Keeping the feet hip distance apart. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. Gaze up. And exhale, hinge from your hips and fold forwards over the legs. Inhale, take a halfway lift to create space. And exhale, fold back down. Keep the knees bent as much as you need to. Inhale, reach the arms all the way back up to standing. And exhale, hands come into prayer, heart center. Nice, keep moving with your breath. One more like this. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hinge and fold forwards. Inhale, halfway lift, create space. And exhale, fold back down. Inhale, reach the arms all the way back up overhead. And exhale, hands come into prayer, heart center. This time, pause and find your Tadasana. Heel toe the feet together, bring the big toes to touch. Ground down into the earth beneath you through the soles of your feet and rise up it through the crown of your head. Take one more deep inhale through your nose. And exhale with a sigh. Again, we flow from here. Inhale, reach the arms out and up, gaze up. And exhale, hinge from your hips and fold forwards over the legs. Inhale, take a halfway lift, create space. Exhale, fold, plant the palms. Step the feet back to find your high plank. Lower your knees, chest and chin down towards the mat. Inhale, slide forwards, find your baby cobra, gentle back bend. And exhale, tuck the toes, lift the hips up and back, downward facing dog. From here, on your next inhale, begin to lift your right leg up and back behind you, three leg down dog. And when you reach the top, open out your hips, stack your right hip on top of your left, bend the top knee, point the toes of the lifted leg, creating space across the front of the body, the front of that right hip. Take one more inhale. And as you exhale, come to square the hips back off, draw the knee forwards, and step that right foot to the outside of your right hand at the top of the mat. You can give it a helping hand to get there if you need to. We're coming to find a lizard lunge. To begin with, staying up on the palms of the hands, back knee stays lifted, and just gently begin to rock back and forth. Taking a moment here to notice how this feels in your hips. And then coming to find stillness just for a couple of breaths. You could stay up on the palms, or you could lower your elbows down towards the mat. You could keep the back knee lifted or drop the back knee down, untuck the toes. Keep squeezing the right knee in towards the right shoulder, creating space in the hips. Take one more deep breath here. And then on your next inhale, everybody come back up onto the palms of your hands. Tuck under the back toes, lift the back knee. And from here, ground down through the palm of your left hand and reach your right arm out and up. And we come to take this wide, easy twist. Inhaling at the top. And as you exhale, begin to cactus that right arm. So bend the elbow, palm facing open. And just notice if this allows you to create more space across the front of the chest. Take one more inhale here. And as you exhale, lower the right hand down onto the mat. And step that right foot back to meet the left in your down dog. Inhaling at the top and exhaling here. Inhale, rise high up onto your tiptoes. And exhale, begin to walk the feet towards the hands at the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift, create space. And exhale, fold. Inhale, reach the arms all the way up to standing. Gaze up towards the thumbs. And exhale, hands come into prayer, heart center. And as you find stillness in your Tadasana, just notice here if one side of your body feels different to the other. Reconnecting with that even, steady rhythm of breathing. Before we take it on to the other side. As you next inhale, reach the arms up, gaze up. And then exhale, hinge from your hips, fold over the legs. Inhale, take a halfway lift, create space. And exhale, fold back down, plant the palms, step the feet back to find your high plank. Again, lower knees, chest and chin down towards the mat. Slide forwards to find your baby cobra, gentle back bend, maybe taking the weight out of the palms. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift the hips up and back into your downward facing dog. When you arrive on your next inhale, lift the left leg up and back, three leg down dog, and then begin to open out the hips. So stacking left hip on top of right, bending the top knee, pointing the toes of the lifted leg, creating space across the front of your left hip. Take one more inhale here. And as you exhale, square off the hips, draw that knee forwards, and come to step the left foot to the outside of your left hand at the top of the mat. Coming to find our lizard lunge. And to begin, just take a couple of rocks back and forth, moving with your breath, easing into the hips, noticing how the body feels on this side. And then finding stillness, settling into your version of a lizard lunge. You could keep the back knee lifted or drop the knee down, untuck the toes. You could stay up onto the palms of your hands, or if you have space, begin to lower yourself down onto the elbows. Gaze forwards towards the top of the mat. And keep breathing here. Squeezing the left knee in towards the left shoulder as we open through the hips and the lower body. One more deep breath. And then on your next inhale, gently begin to lift yourself back up onto the palms of your hands if you're not there already. Tuck under the back toes, lift the back knee, ground into your right hand, and on your inhale, lift that left arm out and up, finding this wide leg easy twist. Maybe your gaze comes up towards the top hands if it feels okay on your neck. Take an inhale here. And as you exhale, can you take that cactus shape with your top arm? Bend the elbow, palm facing open. Noticing if this allows you to create more space across the front of the chest, into the shoulders. Take one more inhale here. And as you exhale, lower that left hand down towards the mat. And then sweep your left foot back to join your right into your downward facing dog. Perhaps taking a moment to pedal out through the legs here. Noticing any space created in the body, around the hips and the shoulders. One more inhale through your nose. And exhale, release with a sigh. On your next inhale, rise high up onto your tiptoes. And on your exhale, again, begin to walk your feet towards your hands, but this time lower your bum down onto the mat and come to find a seat. Extend the legs out in front of you, finding your Dandasana staff pose. Take an inhale, reach the arms up alongside the ears. And then as you exhale, hinge from your hips and fold the body over the legs. Now you can bend the knees as much as you need to here. Arms can rest down along the side of the shins, perhaps the outside edges of your feet. Gaze towards the toes. And just taking a couple of deep breaths here. Opening into the back of the body. Reconnecting with that even, steady rhythm of breathing. On your next inhale, begin to lift the head up, walk the hands in towards the body. Bend up both knees, plant the soles of your feet down onto the mat. Make sure there's plenty of room behind you. And slowly lower your back down onto the mat, drawing both knees in towards the chest, and giving yourself a hug, taking a rock side to side. And from here, we come to take a spinal twist. So extend the arms out alongside the body, palms facing open towards the ceiling. Inhale, draw the knees in towards the chest. And as you exhale, allow the knees to drop over to your right hand side, gazing over your left shoulder towards your left hand. You could bring the right hand on the left knee to add a little bit of weight into your twist. And once you've found the twist that feels right for you in your body this evening, just come back to find your breath. Allowing the body to relax into this twist. One more deep breath on this side. And as you next inhale, gently begin to roll back down, find the center. And as you exhale, allow the knees to drop straight over to your left hand side, gazing over your right shoulder. Taking the twist to the opposite side of the body. You could perhaps bring your left hand to your right knee, deepening the twist. And here, as you inhale, feel the belly expand with your breath. And as you exhale, allow the body to release into the twist. Easing out through the back. Allowing all the muscles in your body to begin to soften here. And then on your next inhale, gently begin to roll back down. Find the center and hug the knees back in towards your chest, giving yourself one last big hug, one last tight squeeze. Take an inhale through your nose. And as you exhale, release arms and legs down onto the mats and release that breath with a sigh. Coming down to find your relaxation. And on your way down, if you want to grab any extra layers, a cozy blanket or some socks, now is a nice opportunity to do so. I'm going to leave you in your Shavasana today. So get yourself as comfy and cozy as possible. And then when you're ready, extend the legs down onto the mat, feet drop towards the outside edges. Arms rest down alongside your body, palms facing open towards the sky. Closing down the eyes. Allowing your breath to return to its natural rhythm. And as you find stillness, allow the weight of the body to feel supported by the earth beneath you. Staying here in your Shavasana as long as you like. We're just taking a moment of gratitude for our practice this evening. and for the wonderful body we have to practice with. Namaste.